sana katika ibada yetu na mafundisho ya jioni ya leo, ambapo katika nyumba nimetembelewa na mgeni. Mgeni kwa majina ni Evangelist Karisa, pia ni daktari nutritionist. Na kabla ya hiyo tutazungumza juu ya maombi, ambapo maombi ni topic ambayo tuko tunaendeleza kutoka siku ya Jumapili, ama tulikuwa tukiendeleza wiki iliyopita, last week but one, na kidogo tutaguzia pale tuliachia, ili pia tuweze kufundisha juu ya our LD. Mtazamaji, liko katika kanisa la Mtwapa AIPCA. Kanisa la Mtwapa liko pale maeneo ya Msambarauni, maeneo yale ya Mtwapa kama unaelekea Kikabala. Mtazamaji, majina ni Deacon Joseph Wetonga, na shika katika kanisa hili la AIPCA, na kwa sasa anatumika katika huduma yangu kwa kanisa la Mtwapa. Na mtazamaji, tuko mmoja kwa moja unapotazama katika mtandao yetu ya YouTube na ile ya Facebook, Mtumishi Wetonga Live na AJSMS TV. Without us, it is because of your love alone that we survive. You know, we have come so that you can share your word. We have come so that you can learn from you. I now pray because of my viewer, wherever she or she is, oh Lord. Join us together as we break this bread of love, as we speak about prayers and how prayers are in our life. And as well, we are going to get our guests speaking about our healthy and our families, oh Lord, that our families and our healthy will not be the same again. After the session which is about to come, things are going to change in our lives and ours. Is to thank you and to glorify your most high name. We pray that shortly we live and trust in Jesus' name. We pray, amen. Amen. Mtazamaji, asante kuweza kuwa nami. Kama vile nimekuambia, majina ni Wetonga Joseph, ama Deacon ni Wetonga Joseph, na kuhudumia nikiwa katika maeneo haya ya Mtwapa. Mtwapa iko Mombasa, Mombasa, Kenya. Tumepakana Mombasa na Kilifi County. Kanisa yenyewe katika county ya Kilifi, lakini mpaka wa Kilifi na Mombasa. Mtazamaji, wiki iliyopita tulikuwa tunazungumza juu ya maombi. Tukatia pale tuliongea juu ya Lord's Prayer. So leo tunasonga sana, kwa maana tunaenda kuongea juu ya more faith. We are going to speak about more faith in us. Now that's why I'm calling upon you that we'll be together and our Lord is going to bless us. You may feel you don't have enough faith to pray, but if you have even the faintest inkling that someone might be listening, that's all it takes. If you have enough faith to ask for more faith, your faith is not so small after all. Anyone who comes to God must believe that He is real, and that He rewards those who truly want to find Him. That you are going to find from the book of Hebrews chapter 6. And when you read, you will find how important it is to have faith. And even the little you have, you may think is small, but according to the word of God, how it is telling us, even that little faith matters a lot in your life. And my viewer, this is the prayer I would like you to pray today, that dear God, thank you for that you do not require, thank you that you do not require us to know all the answers. Thank you that you reward those that earnestly seek you. God, I want more faith. Help me to believe. Amen. That's the prayer that I would like you to do, to have today. And now, there's something we call confession. In the Bible, you find the story of King David, a good king who made a very serious mistake. He wanted another man's wife. You know about that? So he arranged on how her husband to be killed in battle. When he realized what he had done, he was reckoned with guilty. Psalms 51 reckons his heartfelt prayer for forgiveness. God did make a way back for him, and David's story offers us the hope that we are never the God, God's love. If David was able to be forgiven by God, even you, my brother and sister, you can be forgiven. Doesn't matter what you've done in life, but you can be forgiven no matter what you have done. So I beseech you this afternoon, it doesn't matter how you have been, it doesn't matter how you have seen the world has been against you, how you have been used by devil. Today you can turn from devilish characters and come to Jesus, who can welcome you in his love and be one of those who will get eternal life. Be merciful to me because you are loving, because you are always ready to be merciful. Wipe out all my wrongs from above. So that was one more confession that I want us to have. You take away my sin, tell God to take away your sin, and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be white and snow. Create in me a pure heart, God, and make my spirit right again. When you read the book of Psalms, verse 1, you'll find that from verse 2 up to verse 10. And then there's something we call direction. The direction, sometimes we can feel overwhelmed by a different decision or bewildered by the many directions our lives could take. How do we find the way ahead? If any of you needs wisdom, you should ask God for it. That's the book of James chapter 5. If any one of you needs wisdom, the Bible is telling us we should need it, we should ask God. He's generous and enjoys giving to all people, so he will give you wisdom. So we hear that God is ready to give us wisdom so that we can survive as people of God. Sometimes you may find things happening in a way you don't understand. God is ready to supply you with wisdom. You ask us just to have faith, to confess your sins, and turn to Christ Jesus in your prayers, and things are going to be well, and your life will not be the same again. So as you pray today, confession of your sins is very important. Turn to Jesus, and he is ready to give you wisdom, and you will live a life worthy. Now, before I end, I would like to pray to you, with you who want to be born again. If you want to be born again, whereas you are, just say, Jesus, I come before thee, I confess my sins, I'm ready to turn away from all devilish, from the world doings, and turn to a cross, your salvation, I'm ready for it, and now, release me from the book of death. In Jesus' name, help me to live your ways, because you are my God. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. God bless you as you are, my viewer. My name is Deacon Getonga. Addressing that topic about prayers, trying to ask you to continue to pray God all in your life. So I ask you not to go offline, because in the studio, I have a visitor. Katika studio zetu leo tuko na mgeni ambaye atajitambulisha, ni daktari. Na huyo mgeni pia anapenda sana kuzungumza juu ya vyakula na afya zetu, yani afya zetu, na pia anazungumza juu ya familia zetu. Kuna vile amejipanga leo na nitamuita hapa. Naomba mgeni ukaribie katika studio zetu. Naomba ukaribie ndani ya nyumba. Amefika ndio huyu. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Welcome so much.
Thank you.
Karibu sana.
Asante sana.
Our viewer is ready to hear from you. And now I would like us to tell us, is there waiting eagerly to hear, who is Karisa?